In order to calculate these two quantities, so average kinetic energy of the electrons and average velocity of the electrons, so how we can start to solve the problem? We can start to solve the problem by considering the energy distribution. Okay, this energy distribution of electrons. What is the Fermi-Dirac law or energy distribution of electrons? So this is the energy distribution expression. Okay, nu du. So nu du equal to we separately did this derivation in the earlier class. So nu du equal to h root 2 pi v divided by h cube. Then again multiplied by m to the power 3 by 2 e to the power half du divided by e to the power alpha multiplied by e to the power u by kt plus 1. Okay, so this is the expression for energy distribution of the electrons, free electrons, or to be precise, fermions. Okay, so what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the energy of the electrons. Okay, okay, now rearranging. So you have to rearrange this expression in a given way, in some way. Why we have to do this type of rearrangement, that we'll see very soon. Okay, so what we are doing, we are multiplying this both numerator and denominator by 2. Okay, if you multiply by 2, we have 16 root 2 pi v, and here this 2 comes. Okay, again, another two terms we have to mention. So 3n, we have to multiply the numerator by 3n, okay, like this. And the denominator should also be multiplied by 3n. And the rest of the terms, this m to the power 3 by 2 e to the power half du divided by e to the power alpha multiplied by e to the power u by kt plus 1, this much term will remain as it is. So now, okay, you can substitute the value of alpha, okay, in that particular expression. So what is alpha? Alpha is your, what is the value of alpha? Alpha value can be expressed in terms of the Fermi energy, okay? So we already know this value when we are doing this Fermi Dirac distribution law, when we are deriving. So alpha is equal to minus uf over kt, okay? And also expression for Fermi energy, we calculated separately, okay? In another class, we also saw how you can calculate the Fermi energy. So that is uf to the power 3 by 2 is equal to 3 nh cube divided by 16 root 2 pi v m to the power 3 by 2. Okay, so this is the expression for Fermi energy. So this value we did find out separately in another class. That's why you see in the value of Fermi energy, we have these terms, 16 root 2 pi v and 3n, okay, 3n and 16 root 2. And the rest of the terms, that's why we had to rearrange the previous expression for energy distribution of the electrons. So 16 root 2 pi v and 3n, that's why these terms were introduced. Okay, that's why we had to rearrange this particular expression. Now now the substitute the value of, you see, you find out this quantity, you find out this particular quantity here. So 3 nh cube, 16 root 2 pi v m t 2, 3 nh cube, 3 nh cube, and 16 root 2 pi v, then m to the power 3 by 2. Okay, so this much quantity stands for what? Uf to the power minus 3 by 2. Uf to the power minus 3 by 2. Okay, uf to the power 3 by 2 is 3 nh cube by this, then UF to the power minus 3 by 2 is this quantity. Okay, I just highlighted here, and this quantity UF to the power minus 3 by 2. So 3n by 2 will be there, 3n by 2 there, UF to the power minus 3 by 2 will also be there. Then you have du and divided by e alpha e to the power u by kt plus 1 will be as it is. Okay, so it will be as it is, provided you have to substitute the value of e to the power alpha by e to the power alpha. Okay, e to the power alpha value is nothing but minus uf. Uf stands for Fermi energy, so alpha is equal to minus uf by kt. Okay, so we found it out separately when we were learning the topic of Fermi energy of the electrons. Okay, then alpha value was calculated. So this is suppose equation number one. Okay, so now how we can calculate the value of energy, average value of energy of the electrons. The calculation is shown here, but now let us start from equation one. Okay, this equation, after rearrangement and after putting the values of Fermi energy, we have got. Okay, so average kinetic energy at 0 K, T equal to 0 K, when temperature is equal to 0 Kelvin, what is the average kinetic energy that we have to find out? So in order to this expression, you have to consider, remember first, okay, which expression? U bar equal to integration from U to EF, so U nu du by n. So this expression, first you have to remember that if we have to find the energy, how we can do it. So energy will be, suppose energy of each electron, U, multiplied by the number of electrons having that much energy, nu du. That much energy means the number of electrons having energy between U and U plus du. Just a second, U and U plus du. So suppose U is the energy of a given electron, and how many electrons are there in an energy interval of U and U plus du. That is why we have to consider this particular expression, and which is again the distribution of electrons. Okay, energy distribution of electrons. Okay, as per Fermi Dirac statistics. So you multiply energy of a given electron, then the number of electrons in a given interval of energy, okay, divided by, suppose, total number of electrons. Are you following? So, but remember, since you are finding the number of electrons nu du in a given range, so for the whole range, what you have to do? You have to integrate that expression. You have to integrate that expression from U to UF, from 0 to UF, okay, UF being the Fermi energy, okay. So you understood it. So U bar, so average energy is each energy of each electron multiplied by the energy distribution divided by total number of electrons, provided you have to integrate that term in the numerator. Okay. Okay, but before we come to this calculation, how we can modify the value of nu du again? Nu du value we have to modify. So how we can modify? Because we have to calculate the value of energy, average energy at 0 Kelvin. Okay, at 0 Kelvin, we need to calculate the energy. So at 0 Kelvin, T equal to 0 Kelvin. See, when you have to measure the energy at zero Kelvin, okay, then what is one thing we have to consider? That you have to know that at T equal to zero Kelvin, the energies of all the electrons will be less than the Fermi energy. The energy of all the electrons will be less than the Fermi energy. That means at T equal to zero Kelvin, the electrons, none of the electrons will occupy any energy level above the Fermi energy level, right? I repeat, at temperature T equal to zero Kelvin, none of the electrons will occupy any energy level above the Fermi energy level. So any value of energy of the electron would be less than the Fermi value, Fermi level energy. That means U minus UF will be a negative quantity. U minus UF will be a negative quantity. Why? Because U is less than UF at zero Kelvin. So what is the definition of Fermi energy? Fermi energy, the definition is simply at zero Kelvin temperature, the maximum energy level occupied by electrons is the Fermi energy level, okay? And the energy corresponding to that Fermi energy level is the Fermi energy. So same thing here, U less than UF, U will be less than UF, so it is a negative quantity. But again, we have temperature T equal to zero Kelvin, okay? So substitute the value here, U minus UF by KT, okay? So let us find the value of this exponential term, then we can calculate the value of the rest of the terms. So e to the power e minus e to the power u minus uf is a negative, u minus uf is negative, divided by kt, k multiplied by t is zero. So this term, something divided by zero is what? Something divided by zero is infinity. So e to the power minus infinity will have here. Okay, e to the power minus infinity. So minus because u less than uf, and infinity means we have to divide by temperature of zero Kelvin. So we will have e to the power minus infinity. So e to the power minus infinity means 1 by e to the power infinity. 1 by e to the power infinity means 1 by infinity, and 1 by infinity is nothing but 0. Any number divided by infinity gives us 0. Therefore, this exponential term has a value of 0. Okay, I hope you have understood this numerical part. Then, yeah, then what is the value of nu du from equation one? From equation one, nu du is will be equal to, nu du is equal to 3n by 2. We have 3n by 2. Uf to the power minus 3 by 2. Uf to the power minus 3 by 2. U half, we already have u half. You have du, okay? But the exponential term, what is the exponential term? This exponential, okay, exponential term is this one, because plus one is separate. Plus one is not included in the exponential quantity. So this term is equal to zero. We have calculated zero plus one. So you have du, this is where we are living, okay? This is where we are living. So nu du is 3n by 2, uf to the power minus 3 by 2, u half d. Okay. So that is where we are living it. So that is, suppose, equation number one. Okay. So what we have done so far, we have calculated the value of nu du at T equal to zero Kelvin. So the, because we have to calculate the average energy at zero Kelvin. Okay. So that's what we have done. Okay, so now, so I hope you have understood up to this. So now average energy formula I have already explained like this. Okay, nu du is the energy distribution in a given interval of energy. So u bar equal to zero uf nu du by n. Okay, total number of electrons. So what is nu du value? Nu du value is this one. So here, which terms are constant? Okay, since we have this integration, which terms are constant? So 3n by 2 is constant. Uf to the power minus 3 by 2 is a constant as well. Okay, so 3n by 2 by 2n. Okay, just substitute this value of nu du. You substitute. Okay, so this much term is constant. Okay, so uf to the power minus 3 by 2 is also constant, although once it has been written inside, because the Fermi energy is always constant under a given condition and for a given metal. Okay, which part is not constant? The u terms are not constant. Okay, u term. So u multiplied by e to the power half is e to the power 3 by 2 du. Okay, we have to write like this. Uf is a constant term. Okay, uf is a constant term, and like this. Okay, so u bar will be what? U bar will be the rest of the calculation. U bar is 3 by 2 uf to the power minus 3 by 2. So then uf to the power 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2. Okay, so this much if you integrate, so we from 0 to uf, so you will get uf to the power 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2. Okay, then I cancel, simplify, we will be left with the average value of one electron is equal to 3 uf by 5. Okay, just calculate this integration, you can find the value. So this equation gives the average kinetic energy of one electron or per electron at zero Kelvin. At zero Kelvin, this equation gives the value of average kinetic energy. Okay, what is the total energy of the system of n electrons at t equal to zero Kelvin? Total energy of n number of electrons would be simply multiply this expression by n, so which will be 3n uf by 5. 3n uf by 5. So u, capital U, is equal to n u bar, n number of electrons, u is the average energy of a given electron. So the value we have found out, 3 uf by 5, and u equal to 3n uf divided by 5. Okay, so this is the total energy of all the electrons in terms of the Fermi energy. Of course, don't forget that at zero Kelvin of temperature. Okay, yeah, so so two concepts you have to remember. What is the expression for energy? What is the energy distribution of the electrons as per Fermi Dirac distribution law? Then what is the value of Fermi energy? That is also important. So this expression you should try to remember. And then substitute the values, rearrange the distribution, substitute the values, then consider the temperature, substitute the value of temperature. Remember, at Fermi energy, the energy levels are either equal to or less than zero, okay? Because the maximum value of energy at zero Kelvin can be the Fermi energy. It cannot be greater than that, okay? That's why it will be negative quantity preferably. And by zero divided by zero, so it's zero. So that's how we have simplified the expression for nu du. So then find the average value of an electron energy, and you get this. Yeah, okay, so practice this. Okay, these things require practice. So now I cannot tell you if this derivation will be asked in your future exam or not. I cannot tell you, but may be asked, may not be asked. Okay, since we have discussed, so consider this, it may be important. But sometimes if you go for competitive examinations, etc., this value you have, this is 3, okay? 3 by 5 anywhere. Okay, so this is 3. So this value you should remember, because for your future admission test or competitive examinations. Okay, so average and so total energy we have calculated. Now another question is velocity, average velocity at 0 Kelvin temperature. So how is, so energy values we have learned already, okay? Or with this Fermi-Dirac distribution law, we already know the expression in terms of energy, okay? Fine. So how is energy related to velocity? So all of you know this relation since your high school days. So U equal to mv square. So U stands for energy, kinetic energy, and V stands for velocity. So one thing, this energy expression in it can vary from textbook to textbook. Okay, in some textbook you can find it to be written as capital E, like that, and this U bar may be written as E bar. So E and U, so same value of energy, but this representation may vary from textbook to textbook. So that doesn't matter. So how you express it, okay? Anyway, so let's calculate the average velocity again at 0 Kelvin of temperature. So energy converted to velocity, U equal to half mv square, we all know. Differentiate now, du. Because in the energy expression, you see, where are we? In energy expression, this energy distribution expression, we have a quantity du. So du quantity, now we have to convert it to dv, energy convert to velocity. So subsequently all other quantities will also change. So how this change takes place? U equal to half mv square, so du is equal to half m and twice v dv. So half up cancels, get cancels. So du equal to mv dv, okay? Okay, so now accordingly we have to make the substitutions. So another thing we have to consider. So Fermi energy, this is the normal energy expressed in terms of normal velocity. But as per this, how can you express Fermi energy? Fermi energy UF, okay, this is U, okay, this is not V, this is U actually, not V. So UF equal to half MVF square. So where Vf stands for Fermi velocity, fine? So Uf to the power minus 3 by 2. So Uf to the power minus 3 by 2, why we are doing it? Uf to the power minus 3 by 2, because we have rewritten the expression for expression something like this, Uf to the power minus 3 by 2, okay? Refer to equation number 1, we have written in the previous treatment nu du in terms of Uf to the power minus 3 by 2. Okay. So Uf to the power minus 3 by 2, so half mvf square to the power minus 3 by 2. So Uf to the power minus 3 by 2 is half to the power minus 3 by 2. If you break all quantities, n to the power minus 3 by 2. And then Vf to the power minus, Vf square is there. So square 2, 2 gets cancelled. So Vf to the power minus 3 only we have. Okay, so substitute these values now here in equation number 2. Okay, because we are again calculating at T equal to 0 Kelvin. T equal to 0 Kelvin, this exponential term will have a value equal to 0. So the energy distribution is written like this. Okay, so so nu du is this one from equation 2, that is what directly we have written here. So now in place of nu du, you write it as nv dv. In place of u, you replace u by v, you replace du by dv. Subsequently, you have to replace all these U values by V values. all these u values by v values. So 3n by 2, it will be as it is. So uf to the power minus 3 by 2. So substitute this value, half to the power minus 3 by 2, m to the power minus 3 by 2, b to the power minus 3. U to the power half, u is what was the value of u in terms of v. So u value was half mv square. We have already considered here. Yeah. So half mv square to the power half, and du value we already calculated. Du is nothing but mv dv. Okay, mv dv. So simplify the value of nv dv. So nv dv. Okay, now just do the simplification. Okay, so I have not shown this intermediate parts. After this simplification, all these things, we will get something like this. So 3n vf to the power minus 3 v square dv. Okay, so we'll get something like this. You have to be a bit patient and calculate, simplifying, okay, rearrange, and you will get this. Okay. Okay, so now how can you calculate the average velocity of the electrons? So average velocity of the electrons can be calculated the same way as we found out the average energy of each electron, this integration formula. So u bar equal to nu du, u multiplied by nu du divided by n, and the numerator term is integrated from 0 to uf. So here, same thing. So here, instead of u, you have to multiply it by v. Suppose v is the velocity of each electron. Okay, so velocity multiplied by nv dv value we have just derived, v multiplied by nv dv by total number of electrons. So this would give us the average velocity of the electrons. Okay, so substitute the value of nv dv, 3n vf to the power minus 3 v square dv. Okay, so 3n is there, divided by n is here. Okay, 3n by n, vf to the power minus 3, then 0 to vf, v cube dv. Okay, so 1 v is here, and if multiply this v with v square, that's why we are getting here as v cube dv. Okay, so v bar is equal to 3, so nn gets cancelled, 3 vf, vf is constant. Okay, Fermi velocity is constant, because this Fermi velocity refers to the velocity of the electrons at the Fermi energy level, corresponding to the Fermi energy level at zero Kelvin. So it is a constant value. Okay, so Fermi velocity is constant, vf to the power minus 3 by 2. So this term you integrate, so vf to the power 4 divided by 4 is what we will get. Okay, so vf to the power minus 3 multiplied by vf to the power 4. So what will be the quantity? It will be only vf. Okay, so v bar is equal to 3 vf by 4. Okay, v bar is equal to 3 vf by 4. Okay, this is the quantity which you get. Okay, so that's how we can calculate the average velocity of an electron in terms of the Fermi velocity.